My $1,000 Toothbrush by Ishani Sahu. Ever heard of Sam's Club? Yeah, so it's basically Costco, except the membership is cheaper, which, in my opinion, is a pretty darn good deal. But my family and I frequently go there to shop for food, electronics, and occasionally even furniture. However, there was this one day that completely changed my mind on their free samples. Yes, free samples. You see, my mom approached a sales lady who was selling kitchen knives made for cutting smaller foods quicker and easier. We decided to get a knife for free, not like we were going to do anything bad with it. But fast forward a couple of days later, it was my 13th birthday, the day I was turning into a teenager. Now, one wonderful family gave me two Amazon gift cards, both worth $25. Oh, and $50 at 13 years old is considered jackpot, so I was basically rich at the time. But I constantly pondered about what I could spend my money on, possibly brand new clothing, makeup, or even video games. That was until I found out that my money was actually spent on an electric toothbrush that my orthodontist recommended me. Now, you're probably wondering, Ishani, why is this important? Why do we need to know that your money was casually spent on an electric toothbrush and your mom casually grasped onto a knife? Well, you see, as human beings, we all are curious and foolish in ways that could potentially hurt us, even if we don't want to be hurt or even if it wasn't our fault. This was exactly one of these instances where I ended up spending not $50, but more so around $1,000 on a toothbrush. How so? I remember this day like it was yesterday. It was a Sunday, at around 9 p.m. in my apartment, which my family and I had temporarily stayed in because we were going to move into a brand new house in a couple of months. I'd received my electric toothbrush in the mail and had school the next day. My dad told me to open up the toothbrush when I got the chance to, so knowing that I had to brush my teeth in the night anyways, I decided to open up my toothbrush from its plastic casing by then. Now, since I was moving from my old house to my new one in a couple of months, this meant that any decorations, furnishings, utensils, or any other objects that I didn't necessarily need at the time were packed away and kept in the storage room. One of these objects were scissors, the fundamental utility required to open up plastic packages like the one that my toothbrush came in. You see, this is where things all go wrong. You see, me being me, because there were no scissors around me, I thought, oh, what about that knife that I got from Sam's Club? I mean, knives open up fruits, right? So I'm sure they can open up packages. Yeah, not quite. You see, there were three mistakes I had made at this moment. Number one, I used a knife to open up a plastic package. Never use a knife to open up a plastic package. Number two, the knife was facing me when I was trying to open it. And number three, there was no one there to supervise me. And just like that, in a split second, the knife propelled towards me, landing in the space between my thumb and my index finger. And because it was a Sunday night, this meant that any medical centers near me were closed, leaving my family and I to go to the ER. The USA is known for having an incredibly expensive healthcare system. In fact, according to Harvard, the US spends more on healthcare than all the other wealthy democracies in the world. But in spite of all that spending, life expectancy in the US lags behind that of its peer countries, and many Americans struggle to pay for healthcare. Now, to put this into my perspective of my situation that I'd experienced, a trip to the ER in 2017 cost approximately $1,389. This number has increased by 179% from 2008 to 2017, according to the Healthcare Cost Institute. And what is more concerning about this number is that this is just the price to access medical care in America. It doesn't include extra charges such as IVs, blood tests, drugs, or any other treatments. And along with this, another important note to take is that there are different levels or codes of severity of a physical problem or injury when being brought into the ER room. These codes range from 1 to 5, with 1 being a non-complicated issue such as an insect bite, to 5 being a medical emergency requiring multiple tests. Now, this might be shocking to some and normal to others, but a level 1 injury, or in other words, an insect bite injury, cost approximately $237 in 2017. This rate is still increasing. But through these statistics, it is no surprise that this price clearly exceeds the affordability of sufficient care for an average American. This is even worse for individuals who have inadequate access to healthcare in America, as these unexpected bills make up one of the numerous reasons for poverty. And many health insurance companies don't offer ideal plans to middle-class or lower-class Americans. Notable healthcare policies, such as the Affordable Care Act, which even though has given healthcare to over 20 million Americans, is known for its high and costly regulations, which have led to higher insurance premiums. Oh, and don't even get me started on the American Healthcare Act. It really wasn't ever there. In fact, the president's plan was disregarded and defeated, causing him to shift his focus to tax reform, meaning that they just kind of gave up on it. What I'm trying to say here is that there's an ongoing problem with healthcare that has lasted for decades in this country. People cannot receive proper medical care without having to involve some type of card or cash payment. Healthcare is a very crucial and difficult conflict to solve, especially for 320 million Americans. It is also a very sensitive topic in politics, which many people have different perspectives on this issue. But especially at a time where a global pandemic has caused so many mortalities, at a time where people are at a higher risk for heart disease, and at a time where asthma has evidently increased, inflation of these prices isn't going to do any good for an individual's health concern. Unfortunately, we live in a time and age where money-gouging policies only benefit pharmaceutical companies and billionaires with their profits rather than people, and imposing tax cuts isn't going to stop this. We as a country constantly brag about how our economy is flourishing, with the highest GDP, and how developed we are in general, yet we're incapable of having affordable or even free healthcare, which can easily be seen in developing countries. Whether healthcare is free or not, we as American people deserve to have affordable healthcare regardless of someone's financial status, background, or identity. Someone's price and health is more important than any other concern that there is. Because you can buy a toothbrush, but you can't buy a life back. Thank you.